So, you have a movie for me?
Yes, sir, I do. I was thinking Aladdin, but in live action.
Oh, I think we already have a movie called Aladdin, though.
Right, so I figure we could, you know, do it again, but in a slightly different way.
Is there something wrong with the original?
Absolutely not. Everybody loves it. Robin Williams is irreplaceable as the genie.
Okay, but you're saying we should replace him?
Oh, yeah, of course.
So we just make it again?
Yeah, that's right. I think people are just feeling nostalgic about the original, you know, it was so great.
Is there a reason they can't just rewatch it?
No, there's not. It's very easy to find.
So what would be the point of taking something that people love and trying to recreate it several decades later? I mean, best case scenario, it's as good as the original.
And saying that we should do it because filmmaking technology has improved isn't a valid argument. Like, should we try to repaint the Mona Lisa because we have better paints now? I just don't see why we would do this.
I mean, because money?
Oh, money? I love money.
Yeah, we'd make a bunch of it.
So you make people feel nostalgic and they give you dollars?
They do, many of them.
Oh, wow, I'm all in.
Fantastic.
So what do? Do we do it like shot for shot or what?
Well, no, I think we have to make a couple of things different, you know, to justify charging people like $15 for a movie they've already seen.
Oh, I have an idea. You know that scene in the original where Aladdin gives some kids a loaf of bread?
Yeah.
Well, maybe in this one, instead of that, he gives them some dates.
Yeah, we can do that for sure.
Great, and then the rest could be shot for shot, I guess.
Well, I think we need to change a little more than that, you know, make it a little longer too.
Oh yeah, you think so?
Yeah, I'm thinking we should slap another 30 minutes onto this thing.
Oh, kids love sitting for long periods of time.
That is what they're known for.
Wow, and who do you think we should get to play the genie? I mean, they have some big shoes to fill.
Well, I was thinking we could maybe reach out to Will Smith.
Oh, interesting.
Yeah, I'm thinking he could bring a couple of woos and ha-has to the table.
People do love those noises.
Plus, we can have him do one of those end credit raps.
Another one?
Another one.
Oh, actually, you just gave me an idea. We should get DJ Khaled to come yell DJ Khaled.
Oh yeah, people love that too.
People make a lot of money when that guy says his own name.
I was also thinking we can make the middle part of this movie an unofficial sequel to Hitch.
Oh, so Will Smith helps a guy find love?
Exactly.
I love it. The one thing I'm concerned about is that it might be difficult to make Will Smith actually look like a genie.
Actually, it's gonna be super easy. Barely an inconvenience.
Oh really?
Yeah, I figure we could slap a blue CGI recreation of his face on a blue CGI bodybuilder.
Oh, that sounds like it might give people nightmares.
Maybe,
but you know my one problem with the original movie is that the genie didn't have a six-pack or extremely realistic nipples.
What about the whole thing about him floating, like his lower half was like smoke?
Well, we'll make his lower half smoke when he's the genie, but when he takes the form of a human, he'll give himself legs.
Oh, he's gonna take the form of a normal man?
Oh yeah, a whole lot, cause he has a crush on one of Jasmine's handmaidens.
So you're saying the genie gets aroused by human women?
He does, and I have extremely graphic sketches of how that can work right here.
Oh, definitely don't show me those.
Okay, I'll email them to you.
I'll ignore it and block you.
Well, okay then. Anyway, I was thinking we could also get Guy Ritchie to direct this.
Oh, why him?
So he can do that speed up and slow down effect once or twice.
Does he have experience with musicals?
I think he directed a Madonna music video, you know, back at the turn of the century.
Works for me.
Great.
And what about Jafar? What's going on with him?
Oh, well, you know how in the original he was a scary older man with a deep, intimidating voice like, "Soon I will be the Sultan."
Yeah, classic villain. People love him.
Exactly. So what I'm thinking is we could, you know, go the opposite way with it.
What?
Yeah, we get a way younger guy with a soft little voice like, "Soon I will be the Sultan."
Oh, that sounds significantly less intimidating.
Oh, it will be, but this way we could cast somebody young who's gonna look good on a magazine cover.
What? Why would we want that?
So we can get hot Jafar trending. That's free promotion.
Oh, profiting off of thirsty people is tight.
Yeah, it is.
And what's going on with Jasmine in this one?
Oh, well, we're gonna tweak her story a bit and make it so that she actually wants to be the Sultan.
Oh, very progressive and empowering.
Yeah, we're gonna give her this big new song called Speechless, where she sings about how she won't be silenced.
Wow, how did the other characters react to that?
They won't. She sings it to herself in her imagination.
She's the only one who can hear her big song about not being silenced?
That's right.
Well, okay then. And when is this gonna happen in the movie?
Right when Jafar takes over and has her taken by the guards.
She has time to sing a big song?
Well, the movie's literally gonna stop so she can have a little music video.
Oh yeah, I guess we need to shove it in there somehow.
And after her song, she's gonna give a big speech to the guards and convince them not to follow Jafar, even though he's the new Sultan.
And Jafar just lets her do that?
He does. He just sits there. I guess he was moved by the song.
The one she sang alone in her head?
That's the one.
Wow.
And so yeah, there's gonna be this big climax to the movie. Like, Jafar is gonna teleport Aladdin over to him.
Oh wow, I can't wait to hear him do the evil reprise of that song Prince Ali.
Oh, he's not gonna do that.
Is he gonna turn into a giant cobra?
He's not, no.
Is Jasmine gonna get stuck in a big hourglass?
No, no.
So what's gonna happen?
Well, Jafar's bird Iago is gonna become a You know, bigger bird.
Is that more menacing than a giant cobra?
It is if you're scared of large birds.
I was a little freaked out by Sesame Street growing up.
Same here. So he's gonna chase Jasmine and Aladdin.
I thought you said Jafar can teleport people over to him.
Yeah, but he's gonna go with this big bird strategy instead.
Well, okay then. And is Iago gonna have a fun personality like in the original?
No, not at all. He's pretty much a normal parrot.
Oh, do we know anyone who can voice a bird?
Hey guys, it's Ryan here. Hope you enjoyed that pitch meeting. If you did like it, we have a lot more of these on the channel. And you can let me know in the comment section what other movies you'd like to see these pitches for. Don't forget to like and subscribe and all those things. Maybe share it on Facebook and Twitter. And as always, check back soon for a new pitch. Bye bye.